So when I say optical density is different from physical density. Okay, physical density is can be measured by ratio of taking mass to volume. But optical density cannot be measured like that. Okay, when I refer to optical density of a medium, it is given by the measure of how much the light ray bends when it is going from air into that particular medium. Okay, so that indicates the optical density of that particular medium. So we say different optical densities of different media, then we will have different angles of refraction. Okay, so this is about refraction at a plane surface. Now if you talk about why should the light ray bend when it is traveling from one optical density medium to another optical density medium. If I consider these two examples like air water interface and air glass interface. Now there are total three media what we are considering. One is air, and the second is water, third is glass. Okay. Out of these three, air is optically rarer. Okay. Next comes to optically denser medium is water. Compared to water, glass is little bit more optically denser. So when I consider optical densities, the optical density of glass is greater than that of water, and that of water is greater than that of air. And when light ray is traveling from one medium to the other medium, why is that it is bending? What is changing because of change in the optical density? So actually speaking, it is the speed of light which is changing. So speed of light, when I consider light in the form of waves, and there is an expression for the relation between velocity of a wave, its frequency and its wavelength, given by the expression v is equal to n into lambda, where v is the velocity of light waves, n is its frequency and lambda is its wavelength. Velocity of light in air is greater than that in water. Okay. Similarly, velocity of light in air is greater than that in glass. A light ray traveling from water to glass medium, both are transparent media. Similarly, if I take water glass interface and then check out for the same angle of incidence, whatever we have considered earlier, if I take the same angle of incidence, light ray is bending when it is going from water to glass, but it is not bending as much as it is bending from when it is going from air to glass. The velocity of light is greater in water when compared to that in glass. In these two cases here, if you see, when it is traveling from denser medium to rarer medium, the light ray is traveling away from the normal. Okay, it is deviating away from the normal. Clear? So what we observe so far is, whenever the light ray is traveling from air to water, it is bending towards the normal. Whenever the light ray is traveling from water to air, it is traveling away from the normal. Similarly, when I consider the light ray traveling from air to glass, it is bending towards the normal. And whenever the light ray is traveling from glass to air, it is bending away from the normal. So this is happening because the velocity of light in denser medium is less than that in rarer medium. So to denote, let us say velocity of light in air as a C, okay, and velocity of light in water as Vw. So in the case where the light ray is traveling from air to water or water to air, here it is very clear that velocity of light in water Vw is less than C. C, which is the velocity of light in air. Similarly, when I observe when we say Vg is the velocity of light in glass. Okay. So, and Vg is less than that of C. So that is the reason when the light ray is traveling from air to glass, it is bending towards the normal, and when it is traveling from glass to air, it is going away from the normal.